What you searching for, partner?
I've been gathering some flowers for my wife. She's waiting for me back in the cabin.
That's very sweet of you.
And we've been together 50 years now, me and my darling Annabelle. She's always loved these wild fever few that grow around this place. You know. But she's getting on now in years, and it's hard for her to get up and about. So I want to bring her a lovely bouquet for our anniversary.
I've seen quite a few flowers in my travels, if you'd like to help.
Oh, yeah. Listen, these old fingers ain't what they used to be. Yeah, I'd love it. Sure, bring me any pretty ones you find, huh?
You don't mind, I got a heap of chores to attend to.
Some lessons you gotta learn the hard way.
Come on then. Best get this over with and kill you good.
Mighty generous of you, mister.
Let me get out.
Up, sister. Put them up.
Irish, what are you doing?
Who the hell are you?
Give me that. I'm your old friend Amnesia.
Oh, good. Blimey.
And I've come to tell you, if you ever pretend to forget my name or your debt to me again, I'll make sure you reach heaven before these two ladies. Now get down there!
Oh, no. Mr. Marston. How are you?
Ashamed. Ashamed to know you. What the hell's wrong with you, robbing these gentlewomen and ladies of the Lord?
I thought they was doxies.
Ladies, I'm sorry about this man. He's unfortunately lost his mind to the demon drink. At least I hope he has, and he wasn't this stupid all along. So, please excuse us. Now, Irish, that Gatling gun doesn't work. I find that rather upsetting, don't you?
Oh, heartbreaking. Which is why I was just coming to see you when the drink got the better of me. Come on. I know where we can find parts for you. Motherfucking Mary.
How about a drink or two, mister?
I already got myself a woman, miss.
What you looking at? What you looking at? Huh?
I can't stand to see a man walk around with such a dry pecker. Can I help?
Drunk as I am, my prick's in fine working order.
What a lusty specimen you are. I like that.
That fresh air's got me head spinning like a top. Can't be good for a fella.
Shut up, you lazy drunk. Before I stop your head spinning with a bullet.
I resent that, Johnny. I've been working like a beaver on your behalf.
You've been working like a weasel on my behalf. Bushwhacking defenseless ladies of the cloth? You must have been raised on sour milk, Irish.
What are you talking about? I'm a good Catholic boy.
You're a booze-blind coward.
And you're a hypocrite, Marston. You've robbed just as many innocent folks as me.
I tried to only rob those who had more than they deserved.
Christ, the church has more money
Easy,
than
friend.
Anybody.
Don't go getting all severe.
Where are we going, Irish?
Just to the warehouse here in Thieves Landing. I'm telling you, Johnny boy, it's all set up. We're meeting this pal of mine at the back door of the office. Hobble-tongued feller by the name of Shaky.
And he's got the ammunition we need?
Jesus, stop fretting, will you? I knows about guns front, back, and sideways.
You're gonna be real familiar with mine if things keep on this way.
All right, we're here. Stay close. Damn it. That stuttering bastard said this would be open. Come on, let's see if we can get in around the back.
I'm beginning to lose my patience.
I'm starting to think you're soft on me, Johnny boy. Can't even sneeze these days without you being there to catch the drip.
This is your last chance, you good-for-nothing shyster. You've already wasted too much of my time.
Keep your eyes open. Shaky's all right, but I don't trust the gang of fools he runs with.
Shaky's made the arrangements, and he'll... Oh, shite. Sounds like Shaky's only gone and got himself found out.
All right. Now all we have to do is find out who you work with.
You hear me?
Shaky, you wretched fucking son of a whore. Suck my again!
Oh! Labor relations don't sound like they're exactly... at an all-time high. You sneak in and get poor Shaky loose. I'll go get the wagon. Good luck, Marston. He's a good man, that Shaky.
Again!
All right, work your usual magic. I'll go get the wagon ready.
Ah!
mister. Thank you for your kindness, mister. I thought I was a dead man.
My kindness is only as good as the bullets you can fetch up for me and your friend Irish. Let me down, and you'll be a dead man.
This is gonna be one hell of a fight. Let's head for the door. Follow me. Now we're even.
Half even, Shaky. You still owe me for them morphine pills to calm your nerves. Shaky.
You'll get your half more, you dirty fucking snake.
All right, gentlemen. Let's go.
Fucking buck.
Oh, my virgin ears. Come on then, Johnny boy. Let's go. This is a bad place to be idling, fella. Did you have fun in there, you and Shaky?
I killed a lot of men for this damn machine gun of yours.
I'm sorry I missed all the dramas.
You always miss all the drama. There must be cobwebs growing on that holster of yours.
Someone's got to drive the wagon, don't they? Teamwork, Johnny boy. That's my game, not just the glory like you. I'll get you back to McFarlane.
Irish, You're acting like a schoolgirl. I'm telling you, Irish, that machine gun had better work after all this.
Don't you worry. You won't find a finer piece of artillery west of Dublin. Look out, there's one on the bridge up ahead. Jesus, we really ruffled a few feathers back there.
Seems like half New Austin wants to be dead.
Christ, first sons of bitches!
I hope you got money for a funeral! Just give it up!
I don't know if I can take much more of this. You're shooting right at me! Sakes alive! How many are there? Hell of a team, me and you. We should consider making this a more permanent partnership.
I think I've about had my fill of liars in this life, partner.
Well, I think you're ready for part, Mercer. You got enough ammunition here to take down a small country, fella.
I'm gonna need it. Bill Williamson's got himself an army.
So I guess this is where we part ways, Johnny Marston.
Or maybe not, friend. You're gonna be right alongside me when I take on that fort. After all you put me through, it's time you pull the damn trigger for once. Show me what a big, bad killer you really are.
Yes, of course. What am I thinking? Don't worry, you can count on me. I just hope I don't steal all your glory. Wouldn't be right or proper. Impressive, Marston. We'll have West Dickens's wagon rigged and ready to go soon enough.
I've been waiting for you.
Hello, John. John Marston.
Do I know you?
I hope so. I seem to know you.
I'm pretty good at remembering faces.
Are you? Do you remember Hattie McCourt's face?
Who?
She was a girl Dutch Vanderlyn shot in the head on that raid on the ferry a few years back. Same one you got shot on. Pretty girl. Until her eye was hanging out by a thread of tendon, and her brain was plastered over a wall.
Not really.
Then why would you remember me, friend? You've forgotten far more important people than me.
What's your game, friend?
I don't have a game, John. Listen, sometimes I just wish I'd known more about life. Wish I'd had better guidance. A friend of mine, as drunk as a skunk in the saloon on Thieves Landing. I think he's gonna be unfaithful to his dear wife. Why don't you head over there and see if you can advise him how best to proceed?
What do you think I am?
I know what you are, John. Just if you've got the time, friend.
Off you go now. You'll see me again. Don't worry about that.
Let's go!
Come on.
John?
Marshal?
Gentlemen! It's time. We must go.
Why? What's happening?
Seth has managed to get himself inside. But we can't leave it too long, or they will soon realize how very curious he is and remove him from the premises. Or slit his throat and watch him bleed to death. But for a minute, he will delight and amuse them. That's when he'll get us inside.
Okay.
Marshals of the law, when the shooting starts, take that as your cue to start awarding each other medals.
Huh?
I mean, take that as a cue to get inside and clean up the mess.
Oh.
All I care about is Williamson. It is vital we stop him.
Agreed. That man is a stone-cold killer.
Williamson's a proud fool. The question is which will win out between his pride and his instinct for survival.
Ensconce yourself in the back of my wagon, John, so that we can make our grand entrance.
Come on! Let's go!
All right, good. Now just stay put till I tell you otherwise. That scoundrel Seth had better not let us down. Once we're inside and I've lulled our adversaries into a false sense of security with some beguiling sales patter, I will give you the signal.
What signal?
The moment you hear a sharp rap on the side of the wagon, rise like the phoenix and start shooting like you've never shot before. This is it, my dear boy. The moment of truth. Me and you, John. One last time into the breach. This is going to have to be the performance of my life. I hope my nerves don't get the better of me. I'll be honest with you, John. I'm a little jittery. John? John?
It reeks of miracles back here.
Thank God. I'll be ready with that machine gun, my dear boy. I'll be a sitting duck in there. My good men, what would you say if I said immortality was at hand? What would you say if I told you I could teach you to fly? What would you say if I told you I could turn a man into a beautiful woman? Impossible, yes, once, but no more. Gentlemen, I bring you wisdom from the East. I have here in this wagon some of the finest goods, the best medicines, and the newest inventions available for you and your families. Exotic trinkets from the far reaches of the earth, elixirs that give vigor and strength. And for you men of physical skill and athletic physique, this miraculous elixir can keep the muscles supple and relax the cords. It loosens the joints and gives a feeling of vigor and freshness to the whole system. Why, some men have reported to me that after drinking it for 1 month, they can chew through steel.
What the hell?
It's a trap! Yeah!
Come on!
dang pig. Them cock-sucking sumbitches escaped the other side of the fort.
All right, let's go.
Let's find those bastards.
What the hell?
That's the last of them. We still can't find Williamson anywhere.
Hey! It's the snake oil guy!
General Ann, let me in, for goodness sake!
That fool must be hiding.
Man, it is time to start tearing this place apart and find out where he's cowering!
You thought sense of urgency here, please?
Open the gate! It's the snake oil guy!
Get the goddamn gate open and lock it behind him!
Oh, we've got company, gentlemen. These scoundrels have got reinforcements riding this way.
Oh, my good Lord above. There must be 100 of them.
We looked everywhere.
Hold on! Oh, darn, I missed it.
Mr. Marston, we got a live one. He says, Bill's already run off to Mexico yesterday morning.
You'll never get him.
Javier Escuela. He's gone to see Javier Escuela. That should make things interesting. Where in Mexico?
How should I know?
Oh! Where in Mexico, you little shit?
Someplace near Chuparosa, I think he said. That's bandit country.
Chupa feckin' Rosa? Oh, I'll take you there, John. I'm real popular down there. You just meet me at the ferry. I've got lots of friends down south.
I'll see you at the ferry, Irish.
I'll just get me things.
I'm sorry about this, John. I guess you'll be heading to Mexico.
So it would seem. How is it down there?
Wonderful. A sweet, peace-loving people with the love of social justice. May you always find coin in your pocket. It's been a pleasure spending time with you, boy.
You too, Mr. West Dickens. Marshall?
All right, boys. That's enough.
Go!
glad to see you again. Don't stand on ceremony.
Come on.
No problem if I just...
Excuse me, mister.
Yeah, what the hell do you want?
Look, don't ask how, but I know what you're about to do. You don't want to do this.
The hell are you talking about?
You know what I'm talking about, mister. I'm just here to say I don't think you should go through with it. Your wife, she loves you.
Shit, mister. I don't know who or what you are, but I guess I'm grateful. I guess you're right. I was raised better than this.
Don't mention it. Go on now.
Let's go.
Thank you for saving me. I have a treasure map for you.
Thanks, mister. I could use a little luck.
Yeah.
Easy up now.